Hi everyone and welcome to the second day of my Spotlight on Tim Holtz event. Today I'll be making an art journal after popular demand, so two art journals in 1 week. I'm starting out with my go-to technique, so first of all I'm going to stick down this tissue paper. This is by Tim Holtz and it comes in a roll. As a glue I'm using my gel medium, which is by Ranger, and this is matte. Today's theme is about books and coffee, so I want to have a nice background with text. If you don't have a tissue paper and you want to recreate this idea, then you can always use a newspaper or pages from old books and stick them down. For my background, I'll be using two colors of distress paint, so I'll go with cracked pistachio, which is one of the new colors by Tim Holtz. This is the color that went live on January, and also I'll be using my vintage photo. Now I just realized that my vintage photo cup is dry, so I'll just drop a bit of color on my craft mat and I'll go on applying my color with baby wipes. Now I like to apply my color with baby wipes because that ensures that the paint isn't too thick and I will not lose the details of the background. I want to have that text shown through. So I'm going over the pages again and again, applying and mixing the two colors, and you see that at the end I'll end up with a nice and old looking background. Mixing and blending distress paint is very easy because it reacts with water, but once it dries then it stays permanent. And now I'm adding a bit of vintage photo at the edges just to frame my layout. Just to let you know that on my blog there is a giveaway running the whole week, which is sponsored by Tim Holtz with awesome prizes, so if you haven't done already, make sure to join. And now I want you to see how different looks you can get with the same paint. So in my layout with the birds, I used cracked pistachio, but then I combined it with peacock feathers, and you can see how vibrant the color was, while today I combined it with vintage photo and I get a nice and distressed look. So I'm going all around the edges again and applying just a bit of black soot. This is Distress Paint by Tim Holtz again. I'm not squeezing the bottle at all, I just want to apply a thin layer of paint. And now let's do some stenciling. This is one of the latest stencils by Tim Holtz and it's called Tipo. And I'm going to randomly add some details here and there. Now where I'm adding those letters is totally random. So this is one of the questions that I get all the time. If I have pre-sketched my layout or if I know what I'm doing before I start and go by the plan. So for this layout, for example, I knew I wanted to use books and a cup of coffee, which are stamps by the latest release by Tim Holtz. But I had no idea where exactly I'm going to put them, so I'm working randomly on my background, making sure that I love my background, and I'll take it from there. Of course, at this point I know which quote I'm going to use and the couple of stamps that I'll be using. So this is one of the latest stamps by Tim Holtz and I'm going to use the books, and I'm stamping them on Manila cardstock by Ranger using Archival ink. This is the same cardstock as the tags, so I'm going to stamp the books. And the books come from the stamp set by Tim Holtz, which is called Schoolhouse Blueprint. And this cup of coffee, it comes from the Fresh Brewed Blueprint stamp set. Now, as always, you can find a list of all the supplies that I'm using on this layout just below the video in the description area if you're watching on YouTube. But you can also visit my blog where you can find more photos and a full list of supplies there. I decided to stamp the stack of books twice because I wanted to have a bigger stack of books, and so I can use my scissors and cut out all the images. One of the most common questions that I also get is where I find inspiration. So I usually create layouts about things I love, like books for example that I'm doing today, or about quotes that I have noted down that I think they are nice and motivational. And this is where I decide where everything is going to be placed. So I am going to stick the stack of books on top of each other, and this will make a bigger stack of books that will cover a bigger area on my page. And the cup of coffee is going to go just next to it. So I'm going to create a cluster of focal points on one side of my page. I'm using my scissors to cut out the inside of the handle. And now I'm ready to color all the books as well as the cup. So I decided to go with red for my cup. And that's because I always drink my coffee on my favorite cup, which is red. Truth is that in my art journal layout, there are big parts of me. And I'm making this page just because I love drinking coffee while reading a good book. I also make pages about photography or traveling. And you can make your pages based on what you like. For example, if you love sewing or crafting or cooking, you can make a page for whatever you really love. I have colored my cup of coffee as well as my books using distress markers. These are markers by Tim Holtz and they work great as watercolor markers. So you can always add water and get a watercolor effect. However, for this project, I didn't want to do that. I just want to cover up all the books with colors. I decided to go with a certain color combo. So I'm using only yellow, orange and red to color my books. I will link the exact colors that I'm using to color all the books just below in the supplies area. To color the pages of each book, I'll be using old paper, which I think is the most appropriate color for coloring pages. I started by applying the color with my distress marker, but then decided that it would be easier for me to apply the color by using my distress ink pad as well as one of my finger dabbers. You can probably tell that I love the whole Distress family by Tim Holtz, so I have the same colors in any medium, whether it's a Distress ink pad, a marker, and Distress paint. I'm using again my barn door marker and I'm just adding some details here and there. These were bookmarks that were coming out of the pages. So now I'm ready to add some shadows at the edges. I'll be using my vintage photo and I'll just go around the edges just to make it look more old and add a bit of dimension. I'll do the same thing for the cup of coffee and then I'll be ready to stick them down with my gel medium. Now, if you color an image using distress inks or distress markers, you might find that when you try to cover it up and glue it down using gel medium, you get smudges and smears. Now, if you want to avoid that, as I'm doing here today, you need to make sure that your brush is totally dry. I'm having a dry brush and I'm just dipping it on my gel medium. And as you might have noticed, I'm not manipulating the brush too much over the books. I'm just applying a thin layer of matte medium and just leaving it there to dry. And you can see that I have a perfect result with no smudges and no smear. I am going to speed up the drying process with my heat tool and now with my scissors I'm going to cut out the excess. And as always, I want to add just a bit of shadowing around my elements, my focal points. So here goes my big brush marker. This is by Faber-Castell and it's my favorite color. So I'll go around the edges of the books as well as the cup. And this will kind of bind the elements that I have stick down on my page with the background. Adding some shadow around your elements always helps everything to bring everything together. And remember, what is great about this big brush marker is that it dries permanent. Although I have a few seconds to manipulate and blend the color, it will dry permanent. Once I'm happy with the shadows, I'll grab my white gel pen. With my gel pen, I'm going to add some highlights here and there. Notice that I'm not trying to be neat, I'm not drawing any straight lines here, I'm just being sketchy. I want to have some white highlights here and there. I'm doing the same thing on the cap, but as you can see, I have added too much. What's great about having a non-porous surface by applying and sealing down everything with gel medium is that I can always wipe off my gel pen with a baby wipe. In the stamp by Tim Holtz that I've used for my cap, there are three lines that represent the steam. So I want to have that over my coffee to make it look as if it's hot. So I made sure that I stamped that detail on my layout. And now I can go ahead and add some vintage photo all around my edges. I'll go around the edges again and again until I'm happy with them. I just thought that I needed to add just a bit of color to make my layout more vibrant, let's say. And I am going to stamp my quote on the left page of my layout, and just because I thought it was too plain, I decided to stamp those coffee stains again. This is a stamp by Tim Holtz. For my quote, I'm going to be using two different alphas by Tim Holtz. These are worn text as well as tall text. They are both my go-to alphabet stamps, and I use them on my layouts again and again. I'm stamping them with black archival ink, and to make them pop, I'm going to use my gel pen around them just to add a bit of highlight. I'm gonna let you inside my thoughts at this point. I realized that I didn't like the stenciling that I did on this page. Just because in this page I have the quote with so many black letters, I didn't like having those numbers and characters on top. I'm going to fix that later on. And as you can see, I don't have anything pre-planned. I only have the main idea on my head. So things might go wrong. Now, I used one of those patterns yesterday to create my background. So today I decided to go with the other one and try it out. So I'll go all around the edges. I'm using my archival ink in coffee color instead of black, because I already had too much black on my page with all those letters. And to bring more light on my page, I'll go all around that border that I have just stamped with my white gel pen and add some white details. And now I'll work on the top right corner and cover up that stenciling. I want to bring some red over there, so this will bind it with the rest of the layout. I decided to go with that clock, and this is from an ephemera collection by Tim Holtz. And using my blending tool and festive berries distress ink, I'm covering it up, as well as adding some vintage photo at the edges. I am making sure that my brush is dry, and now I'm going to stick the clock down using gel medium. You will notice that the color does not smudge or smear, and it doesn't come out on the rest of the layout. Even if it does, it doesn't matter, you can really create a nice shadow all around it. So you can work any mistakes at your advantage. I'm making sure that this is dry. I'm going to use my scissors and cut out the excess, and I have a nice red accent at the top. I'm using my brown marker around to create some shadow and blend it in with the rest of the layout. And I'm also going to cut out half of this globe and stick it up there, covering half of the clock. This will ensure that I don't have too much red up on that side, but at the same time, I am trying to make this work out somehow with the rest of the layout. So if I'm talking about coffee and about books, and you want to combine the clock as well as the globe, then I can stick down those two little words that I'm looking at, and I'm going to stick down when and where. So that's because I can read and drink a cup of coffee just anywhere and anytime. And I'm really happy with how this turned out. I just love that I added that touch of red at the top. Now adding some finishing touches with my black and white marker. And that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to give me thumbs up as well as leave me a comment on my YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching.